So babies that are fed formula, their microbiota looks very different than breast milk. And actually what we see is breast milk has a component of it. One of the major components of breast milk is this type of carbohydrate called human milk oligosaccharides, or HMOs. And for a long time, it was really a mystery why those molecules were there, because we knew that humans can't digest human milk oligosaccharides. So why would a mother put so much effort into creating these compounds and putting them in her milk if her baby can't even digest it? Well, come to find out, it's actually the gut microbes that are digesting these HMOs. So in breast milk, there's not just food for the baby in the form of lactose and fats, but these HMOs that are food for the baby's growing microbiota. So the mother's feeding the baby and also her baby's growing microbiota. And these HMOs are very specific for human milk and so far have not been able to be replicated in formula. And so that, we think, is a large reason why the communities are so different. And then, of course, antibiotics. The average American child is on a round of antibiotics every year, and we know that that's a huge, makes a huge impact on that growing community. So all these things that happen early in life could really set a child on a trajectory potentially for having potentially a very good, healthy, robust microbiota, or potentially one that isn't as good. And so I think as parents, especially of new children, we need to be very mindful of the choices that we make early in a child's life, because many of these microbes that we have by the time we're, say, the age of 5, many of these microbes will be with us throughout our entire lives. So we really want to get that community started in the best possible way.